Right, here we are. We will now see how we can make the top part of the bottle, which is here. And now I will set the cursor to be here. So assume that you didn't select any of these vertex. We can say that you didn't select. So you can select by Alt Shift click, and you will select this and going to cursor to selected. And after that, we will make a circle, and this circle will be different because we will make some detail. So I will go to say a vertex of 140, and let's scale down up to this, and I will extrude scale in the Z axis up to this moment, up to this position. And after that, I want to close the top part, so we can extrude scale and fill this area. And again, we can isolate this item and extrude scale. Then we can select all these faces and select shaker deselect, and we can now make the center the cursor to be in the center, and Shift S cursor to selected, and extrude scale Shift Z like such as this. And I think we are now done. We will make some loop cut here and some loop cut here, and we don't want this edge. So let's extrude scale, let's move in the Z, let's move in the Z axis. Right, we will extrude in the Z axis and scale this some times like this. Alright, let's add subdivision surface by making or by clicking Control 2. So after that, alright, so we are now done for this, and I think we can go to shading to be smooth, and let's define some edges to be the inner. I think that we will not see the inner, but in case if you want to make a close up shot, or you want to render the item to be isolated. So I don't know why this has been deactivated. So I think this is a bug in this beta version. I should update this version, but I have added a loop here in the top and the loop also in the bottom, and you can slide this by G twice. Alright, now we are done for this top area or top part. And in the next version, we will render and shoot for the first bottle in our course.